have a constitutional right to travel. We've all heard that there is a right to freedom of speech, the right to peaceful assembly, and the right to form associations under Article 10 of the Federal Constitution. What about your right to travel? Is it guaranteed in the Constitution? My name is GK, and this is GK TV. Now, we have to look at Article 9 of the Constitution. Article 9 states that every citizen has a right to move freely throughout the Federation and to reside in any part thereof. So, there it is. You can move about freely. Let me tell you a story about D.C. Smith. Long before we had gained our independence, in the Supreme Court of Virginia, a case was heard and the judgment was delivered. Would you believe it? On September the 12th, 1930. It concerned a citizen and a police chief in a city called Lynchburg. D.C. Smith was the chief of police. He tried to stop Thompson from driving his private car on the city streets. Now, under Virginia's laws, a person who intended to drive a vehicle on Lynchburg's roads required a permit. For one had to apply for a permit to the chief of police. Now, the law gave the chief of police a right to refuse to issue the permit. It said, "And no permit shall be issued unless such examination shall disclose that he or she possesses such ability and knowledge as, in the judgment of the chief of police," would you believe it, qualifies such a person to receive such permit. Now, before this incident, Thompson had twice been convicted of speeding. The chief of police revoked Thompson's permit, but he couldn't prove that he had sent it to Thompson, or that Thompson had indeed received it. It all depended in those days on the postman. Having heard arguments, the court said, "The provision authorizing the chief of police to revoke the permit of any driver who, in his opinion, becomes unfit to drive in an automobile on the streets of the city is void. The reason for this," the court explained, "was because it is a delegation of legislative power to an administrative officer, a policeman. It authorizes the chief of police to revoke a permit whenever, in the chief of police's opinion, the holder of the permit has done or has omitted to do something, the doing or the omission of which the chief of police thinks renders the holder unfit to drive a car on the streets of the city, without prescribing any uniform rule applicable to all persons alike. The exercise of such a common right, the city may, under its police power, regulate in the interest of the public safety and welfare, but it may not arbitrarily or unreasonably prohibit or restrict it, nor may it permit one to exercise it and refuse to permit another of like qualifications, under like conditions and circumstances, to exercise it. The long and short of it is, in conclusion, you have a right to move about freely and to drive wherever you like. But those rights can be controlled by the authorities, so long as the laws are fair and so long as the laws are uniformly applied. Thank you. If you like this video, press like. If you haven't already, subscribe, share this video widely with your friends, and press that bell. I'll see you again. Have a good day. Goodbye.